dozens of Hollywood stars pen a letter calling for responsible gun depiction in movies and TV shows. The open letter, which was published in response to recent mass shootings in Uvalde and Buffalo, was posted on a gun control nonprofit. The signatories say they are not asking anyone to stop showing guns on screen. What they want is for writers, directors, and producers to be mindful of on-screen gun violence. Suggested measures include showing characters locking up their guns for safety and holding discussions about possible alternatives to guns that can be used. Among the signatories are actor Mark Ruffalo, comedian Amy Schumer, and famed producer Shonda Rhimes. Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau tests positive for COVID-19 for a second time in less than 5 months. He says he feels fine but is isolating. He also took the opportunity to promote vaccination, crediting his lack of severe symptoms to being fully vaccinated and receiving a booster dose. Trudeau initially tested positive for the coronavirus at the end of January. Meanwhile, British rock band Rolling Stones is forced to postpone their gig in Amsterdam after frontman Mick Jagger also tested positive for COVID-19. The 78-year-old singer, who has received complete vaccination, apologized to Dutch fans for the last-minute cancellation, promised they would get back as soon as they can. Philippine agrarian authorities vow to review a land dispute which led to last week's arrests of dozens of farmers and land reform advocates in Tarlac Province. DAR Secretary Bernie Cruz says an immediate and impartial investigation on the matter will be conducted. For the meantime, he called on the more than 200 co-owners of the Collective Certificates of Land Ownership Award to wait for the validated report that will show the official list of qualified agrarian reform beneficiaries in Hacienda Tinang, which is the property in question. The farmers are planning to file countersuits against police due to alleged violations during their arrest. But the Tarlac police deny any wrongdoing.
That is the claim of their lawyers, no? But on the part of the PNP, very clear po, there is malicious mischief. May mga sinira po nga tanim itong ating mga kinasuhan na tao.
Senator Kiko Pangilinan, busy transitioning to a private life after losing in the recent vice presidential race. But he says he will continue to advocate for farmers and fisher folk, which he says play a critical role in the country's food security.
You know, we went around the country campaigning for food security and support for our farmers and our fisher folk. And regardless of the election results, food security is still critical. People will still need to eat, all the more now. Mataas ang patuloy na tumataas ang presyo ng bilihin, pataas ang presyo ng krudo, ng gasolina. Napakasakit para sa ating mga farmers, kaya tuloy pa rin ang ating advokasya.
Pangilinan also urging the next administration to be tougher against agricultural smugglers.
The DA should be, and the BOC, the customs, you know, and the DOF should be front and center in ensuring that there are no sacred cows in terms of bringing in all these imports. Pag walang sacred cows yan, habulin, bantayan yung pagpasok nitong mga smuggled na mga produkto. And you know, the impact on the agriculture sector of smuggled, unchecked products has led to the ASF, the African swine fever. Dahil imported na karne yan na hindi na-check, na kailangan talagang sampahan ng kaso, i-raid itong mga under the Price Act. The DTI and the DA are empowered, you know, to go after hoarders, profiteers, and smugglers, obviously. So it's really enforcement.